take a look at the jam version of my game. And this is how it looks now. So, what did I do? Let me explain my thought process and what I added, starting from the beginning. Here's the same scene without any modifications done to it. No shaders, no effects, nothing. Just the bare sprites. It looks really weird, doesn't it? And yeah, it makes sense, because you're not meant to see it in this form. But the devs have to start somewhere. And that somewhere is the base shader. For this shader, I'm heavily relying on posterization, which I explained in a previous video. The main thing you need to know about it is that posterizing a value breaks it into steps rather than allowing a smooth transition. The way I'm using it here is quite simple. I take the brightness of each pixel and using that information I can make a new color that fits into a palette created by a main color and a few parameters. This allows me to change the hue of the scene procedurally without needing to remake a bunch of sprites to fit into a new color palette. Our scene now looks a lot better because the color palette is consistent across groups of sprites, but it still looks really static. You might not have noticed this because I made it look less boring than it actually is with some editing magic, but it's missing something. Noise! Okay, not that much noise. There we go, that's better now. By adding a bit of noise to offset the brightness before calculating the colors, we break up the static bands of color and instead replace it with something that almost looks like wind. Noise can be used in a lot of shaders to make them more interesting, but I'm not gonna spend too much on this step as it's quite self-explanatory. Instead, I can finally talk about the video's topic, dynamic lighting. So what do I mean by dynamic lighting? If we look at the current scene, it looks really boring because it's missing a lot of contrast overall. Your colors can look like they have good contrast, but it's meaningless if the rest of your scene doesn't. So, what did I do to fix this? Of course, I added some lights. I don't know why, but a lot of people overlook lights for 2D games, even though they are one of the biggest game-changing effects you can add to your project. Lights are super simple to set up and to use, with their only drawback being a performance hit that depends on the game engine you use. There are many ways to use lights, but you need to keep in mind a few things when trying to use them. Tip number 1. Don't spam your lights everywhere. The reason we are adding lights is to make the scene have darker and lighter spots, so lighting up everything won't fix that problem. Tip number 2. Light up important areas first. Bright areas attract your attention, so putting lights near objects that the player should look at or interact with will make them more likely to do so. This is why I placed the candles in these spots for my game. The ones on the left side light up the deck of cards, while the ones on the right bring attention to your hearts and the end turn button. Tip number 3. Vary the intensity of your lights. They shouldn't all be at the same brightness. Think about how much light your light sources should emit, and try to scale the brightness to that. My smaller candles emit less light, and I added a very subtle light to the cards to make them look less flat. You probably didn't notice this, but the lights aren't actually consistent with the color palettes of the scene. Thankfully, Godot has something called the light shader, which is just like the vertex or fragment functions, but instead it handles lights. For some reason, the documentation around it is a bit weird, but after a lot of trial and error, I managed to implement the same color palettes for the light sources as well. This makes the scene a bit more consistent and maybe even more realistic. Now we have a pretty decent looking game. However, there's still one more technique that can make it look even better. Normal maps. This is the ultimate step for great dynamic lighting, because with normal maps, the light interactions between sprites and light sources become way more interesting. Without normal maps, the light sources themselves can look a little bit flat, and this technique solves that in a really awesome way. If you've ever played around with 3D PBR rendering before, you probably use normal maps for the materials. Essentially, these are textures with directional data baked into them that gets used in rendering to add extra lighting detail without actually adding more triangles to your mesh. It's both a really great optimization technique and something that can make your materials look better without much effort. So, how do we make one of these textures for 2D? Well, unfortunately, I have some bad news. You have to make them manually. While many 3D software has the capability to create these textures, you can't really do the same with 2D. And if you're doing pixel art anyway, you probably want a more stylized look to your normal maps as well. So let me share you my process on how I make my normal maps, as I've done plenty of them for Unblight. Please check it out in the description, I've spent way too much time drawing normal maps, so any support is appreciated. Anyways, we're going to be using something that's called a normal sphere. It's basically a normal map that was created from the normal directions of a sphere. From this, we can pick the appropriate colors that fit with the direction we want to express on our sprite. I'll start by filling the flat areas up with the light blue color from the middle of the sphere, as that's facing the viewer directly. After you're done with that, you need to think which way a pixel is facing, and based on that, pick a color from the normal sphere. So if you think your pixel is facing to the right, then you choose a color from the right side. So fill out the rest of the colors and you're actually done with your normal map. It's not that hard to make, but if you have hundreds of sprites or just a few complex ones, it's gonna take a while to do these manually for each one of them. So this is how it looks like. I also made a second version that looks softer, just to show that you can make these in many different ways depending on what you want to achieve. To add normal maps to your sprites in Godot, all you need to do is to create a canvas texture and fill in the diffuse and normal texture slots. After that, make sure you have some sort of light in your scene, because without one, you won't see any changes. So I did this for almost every sprite in my game, and here's the result!